What if I told you that not all legends that are creepy or scary are entirely evil or bad? For example, the Baba Yaga from Slavic folklore chooses to eat, imprison, or help those she comes across. Let's hope she's in a good mood today as we learn about this mysterious creature. The name Baba Yaga is often understood as Grandmother Witch. She is also among the most well-known of the Slavic folklore and is still shared to this very day. Some see her as a way to keep children in line, while others see her as a form of female empowerment and independence. How will you view her? The first written mention of her can be found in a Russian book of grammar dating back to around 1755, but it is believed that she, of course, was told by stories and word of mouth beforehand. She's depicted as a deformed and ferocious-looking large old woman that flies around in a mortar and wields a pestle. The pestle is used to make the mortar fly with one hand, and she uses the other to hold a broom to sweep away her tracks. She lives in a house that stands tall on four chicken legs and lives deep in the forest. The house or hut she lives in can move at the will of Baba Yaga herself, either using the 4 feet or to teleport in a sense. Baba Yaga is said to live outside the norms of society and by her own rules. This is where the belief that she embodies the concept of feminine power comes from. She is also said to be a trickster who may offer her assistance. Sometimes she has a fairy godmother-like role, but with a twist that is sometimes sinister. She has also been known to help heroines and heroes alike to reach their unattainable goal. Some say she is believed to be the personification of nature, which can be evil to some and kind to others. Others believe her to be the interpretation of the goddess of death, or the Slavic version of the Greek goddess Persephone. From what research shows, there is no one true interpretation of what she is actually meant to represent. Other suggested meanings of what Baba Yaga is are change, disease, witches, rage, pain and worry, snakes, horror, and torture. It may be a reader or listener discretion type of creature. Although she represents some good, she is more well known for kidnapping misbehaving children and eating them, thus giving her a Slavic boogeyman-esque type of warning for children to heed so that they listen to their parents. Along with the fairy tale told by word of mouth, Baba Yaga has also been depicted and retold in many different books and movies. One that comes to mind is Bartok the Magnificent from 1999, a good children's movie that is fun for the whole family or to watch by yourself if you like cartoons. After hearing what the Baba Yaga looks like, where she lives, and what she may represent, here are two tales for you to determine if she is anti-hero version of a fairy godmother or an evil witch that commits evil deeds deep in the dark woods. The Baba Yaga usually leaves her house early in the morning. Unlike other legends that go bump in the night, she returns in the evening. Baba Yaga also has a flock of three black geese that fly and circle children they find doing wrong, as told in the story about Olga and Sergei, two children who snuck out of the house while their mother had gone shopping in the village market. The mother told them not to go outside while the black geese were flying around, but Sergei did not listen and was snatched up by the geese for Baba Yaga to eat when he went into the woods. Olga then ran fast as she could into the woods after her brother. Olga then helps a fish, a squirrel, and a mouse on her way to the house. Once at the house, Olga found Baba Yaga asleep, and when she and her brother slid down the legs to escape, Sergei fell and woke up the geese. They then woke up Baba Yaga. When Baba Yaga tried to reach the kids, Olga then used all of the presents she got from helping the animals in order to escape. Olga and Sergei were successful in escaping and returned home as fast as their legs could carry them. From then on, Olga and Sergei never went outside when the black geese were around again. Having heard about where Baba Yaga is a villain, what about her being a helping hand? Look no further than the tale of Vasilisa the Beautiful. Vasilisa was the daughter of a merchant man who lost his first wife. Upon the first wife's deathbed, she gave Vasilisa a small wooden doll talisman. However, like Cinderella, Vasilisa's father remarried an evil stepmother who had a daughter who became an evil stepsister. While the father was away, the stepmother and stepsister would treat Vasilisa terribly. When the father had to take a long journey one time for business out of town, the stepmother wished to do away with Vasilisa. The wicked stepmother sold the house the same day the father left and moved deep into the woods in a gloomy little hut. It was rumored the woods they lived in was also where Baba Yaga lived. While being mistreated, Vasilisa grew and became known to suitors as Vasilisa the Beautiful. This made the stepmother angry. She would then send Vasilisa out of the house in hopes that Baba Yaga would eat her. Vasilisa would always return home, safe, thanks to the doll that her mother gave her. The evil stepmother, one night before bed, told her daughters to put out all the fires except a single candle. The stepsister, on the orders of her mother, put out the candle. Vasilisa was held to blame and was told to go to Baba Yaga's house to find a light for the candle. Vasilisa then went to Baba Yaga's house, guided by the doll talisman. On the way to the house, she sees three different men riding horses, one in all white, one in all red, and one in all black. The riders represent morning, noon, and nighttime. When she got to the house and Baba Yaga found out why she was there, Baba Yaga then has Vasilisa complete tasks to earn the fire. If Vasilisa failed, Baba Yaga would eat her. These tasks were to clean the house and yard, do Baba Yaga's laundry, and cook her meals, which was enough for a dozen people. After 2 or 3 days of Vasilisa doing this and annoying Baba Yaga with many questions, Baba Yaga asks the girl how she was able to do all these chores, which were more than one person could handle. Vasilisa then tells her that the doll that her mother gave her helped. Baba Yaga then becomes angry because she rejects anything blessed, but she also gave Vasilisa the fire in his skull. When Vasilisa returned home, she found out her stepmother and stepsister had not been able to light a single fire in the hut. They were then burned to ashes by the skull lantern sent with her by Baba Yaga. Vasilisa then buried the skull so no one else would be harmed by it. After this, Vasilisa went on to marry the Tsar after being a seamstress for some time in Russia's capital. After hearing this information on these two tales and learning of the Baba Yaga, tell me, do you believe her to be good or evil? Hey, thank you for watching. Click the video on the right to watch my deep dive into the Boo Hag, or click the video on the left to watch weird and creepy stuff caught on camera by Slapped Ham. And as always, have a good day.